I came upon an interesting problem the other day. Someone was trying to take a running total of students' marks in a number of different classes. Now, different instructors complete the different marks on each student on different classes so that the marks for each student are located in different locations in each sheet, and so that things like average if and sum if can't be run on sheets like this because they are looking for a range. Now, you could do, if they're all located on a different sheets, you could do, for example, sheet 1 : sheet 4, and then it would be like B4 if every mark was contained in B4. But considering they're located in different locations on every sheet, you're not able to use either sum if or average if. So what you can do is you can do a sum total of all the marks. So that's simply sum, and then you just select all the marks. And then you'd go to each sheet and get the marks. And in the last subject, the student hasn't completed yet, so it is you're going to have a zero value there. So basically that works out, and you can sum the total of all the marks. Now, since you can't do an average if, what you're going to do is you're going to count how many sheets have marks that are not zero. So what I did here is I created a formula saying equals if, and then I go there, I do an open bracket, and I go to my first sheet, and I say, if this mark is greater than zero, then you're going to put a one there, and if it's not greater than zero, you're going to put a zero there, and you're going to close that with a bracket. Okay, now, to add it to the next one, you're going to have to do plus, and so what we're going to do is we're going to put brackets around this. And we are going to continue the formula for each sheet on the five subjects here. So I'll just pause it for a minute so I can complete it. So this is my formula that is completed with every sheet saying if it's greater than zero, put a one there, and all the way down till we get the four subjects covered. And press enter. And we have three courses that have greater than zero in them. To figure out an average. Now, you're not going to want to do these steps, so let's do a formula that is the combination of the sum, and then you're going to divide by the three. So what I've done is I've copied my formula from here, and I've copied it onto a notepad file, or the program notepad, and then I copied this onto notepad as well. And so now I'm going to divide this by this, and that should get me my average. So there is my formula complete. I have the sum divided by the total of all these if statements that are down in the bottom. And so we press enter. And there you have your 77.7 average. And now we just select it all and drag it all down. And you have a running total of averages for every student in this organization or in this school. That's how you do an average across different sheets if they're located in different locations in each sheet. Please subscribe.